All right, guys, so I have promised you a boat tour, and I think we should do that now. All right, so let's start with the saloon. This is where we have the main area where people can hang out inside versus the cockpit outside. And down here we have a lot of storage. This is where we have all our canned food, and the same in the rest of the sofa. A lot of food mainly. And we also have some food out here, some big nice containers. We use a lot of flour as we bake every day, so these are not tucked away. And also, like, for the breakfast, we eat muesli and so on. Yep. And here we have the kitchen. The stove and the oven where we bake our bread. We have some storage down here as well. And this was actually original a cupboard where you could have a lot of stuff, but as we chose to install an extra fridge, this is now mostly containing the back part of the fridge. We also have one more fridge here. This was here when we got the boat, but we thought we might need some more fridge space, so now we have two. We also have some space up here for stuff. And the same here. And then we have all our spices and stuff in here. Yeah, and we also have a freezer. All right, so this is something that we chose to prioritize in Las Palmas. So we bought this box that can either be a cooler or a freezer, but we use it as a freezer. So this little area here is cooler, and this is freezer. Really important to have Malibu for the piña coladas. Yeah. So it's really, really nice to be able to freeze meat and to be able to have ice cubes and stuff like that. Yep, so this is just tucked away under here. It actually works quite nicely. If we go down here, this is the starboard side, and this is me and Michael's cabin. So we live in here, and I love waking up to this every morning. Reminds me. Yep, so this is our bed. Then we have here, we have some storage for the clothes, and we have some storage down here as well. A lot of stuff in here fits in there. And then we have this little extra cabin that we do not use. We use it for storage. We have some storage space in here as well, and a little TV. Yeah, that was Michael's idea, but yeah, it's quite nice to have watch a movie or series on that one. Yeah, it's really nice to have stuff hanging, because then you have a little bit more space. Out here, we have our library. We have a lot of books that people can just borrow. All kinds of different types. And then we have one of the two toilets that we have. You could actually shower here, because you can pick this up, but we don't use the shower at all. You have to jump in the ocean if you want to shower. And in here we have the other starboard cabin, which is currently occupied by Mona and Pernille. So they just arrived yesterday. This also has quite a lot of storage space, actually. There's a little shelf up there, a shelf down here, and also a little bit of space there, and here as well. So that's quite nice. And let's go upstairs. So while we were still in Las Palmas, Spain, we chose to have a water maker installed. So down here below the floor, we have some hoses and some filters next to the seacocks, and down here in the sofa next to the water pump, we have a membrane and a high pressure pump. And down here we have made a little door to the panel, so this is where you can start it and you can keep an eye on how it is going. The water maker can make 50 to 60 liters per hour, so that's pretty nice. We're really happy with this one. Yeah. In the port side, it's exactly the same. The halls are identical. And this is where Anas and Lilia are staying. She just arrived yesterday, so she's not all finished unpacking. They also have some space down here that we usually use for additional food and storage. Like, this is our grab bag, additional water for the life raft, so ready to pick up. And we also have, I don't know if you can see it, we have a green container down here that is our oxygen if we have a diving accident. Up here we have the same room as in the other side, additional cabin, and that is currently used for storage but is actually going to be used as a real cabin in the future. You can access it through the window or through here. Also have some space up there. All right, so the same as in the other side, one more toilet, exactly the same. Only difference is that this is a manual, and then the other side we have a electric toilet. In here, the last cabin in the port side, and as I said before, it's exactly the same. Only difference here is that we have all our batteries. So this is all the power. We have 10 batteries. We hang this up so that you have some storage now that we took the shelves. All right, let's go outside. One more thing, we have our navigation corner here. So some different stuff down here. And this is the panel where you can switch everything on and off. And then to the cockpit. This is truly one of my favorite places on the boat. It's really, really nice that it is in the same level as the saloon. One of the big advantages of having a catamaran. So you don't feel like you are in two separate rooms. You kind of feel like you're in the same room. So that's really nice. And you can even get someone to serve you a little gin and tonic here, if you're lucky. But this is really the heart of the boat. And here we have all our life vests hanging, and with the lifelines in, everyone has a number so they know which one is theirs. Me and Michael's are separate here. And our generator, a little bit of storage. These can actually stand there when we sail. A lot of people ask us, but they keep to themselves. And Michael's fishing rods are hanging nicely up here when we don't use them. And here we have our nets. So the crew is actually out shopping now. So in a few hours, these will all be filled with greens. So this is all our apples, bananas, whatever, everything is out here. And I hope the wind isn't too bad. I'm wearing this little thaw here. So hopefully you will be able to hear me all right. It's a little bit windy today. So let's start on the other side. All right, so this is where we steer the boat. A lot of people are wondering about this strange looking setup that we have. Originally, both sides had this little seat that you see here. But we just didn't think that it was enough. We felt that it was pretty exposed and that you did not have a good place to be while steering in big waves and bad weather. So we had this little seat made. So this is a wooden seat that you can just pull up, and you can just wrap the strap around it and it will stay there so that you can use the passage when you need to go through. And also this here was made so that you have something to lean against when you sit here. And this can also be removed. So let me just So then you can put it up here, and you can Alright, so now this will stay there and you can access freely here. So you can either sit or you can stand, and you can also stand even when the seat is down. And in the beginning, we actually wanted to have some kind of a little shelter. So we wanted, and we maybe still want actually, something to shield you from the sun or from the rain. But we haven't really gotten around to that yet. So right now we just use it for our flag. Yeah. But the seat is really nice and we really like it and we're really happy with that. So this is where we steer, the compass and all the other stuff you can see here, autopilot. All right, so even though we have two places to steer the boat, you can only use these in the port side, and you also only have these in the port side, so you can only use it if you want to have a better overview of the starboard side. But it's nice enough to have it. So in the starboard side, we have our ladder so that you can easily access from the water. And we have our extra, the small dinghy motor. And here down here, we have both dinghies. So this is our main dinghy, the big one that you have heard all kinds of stories and troubles about, because it's really big and really heavy, but it's also really nice when we are a lot of people. And then the small extra dinghy so that we are a little bit more flexible being 8 people on board. Here we have some additional cans for diesel. I think we have 15 cans. And these are our diving bags. We have 8 of them. And that means that when you come on board, you will get your own bag. So basically you can put all of your gear inside. I'll just open it. 1 second. All right. So the point of this being that you can keep track of all your stuff, so it's not lying around on the boat and you can take good care of it. So here we have, this is my bag, so this is my suit or my wetsuit. And then I have my BCD here. I have my fins, I have my mask, and then we have this little strap so you can hang your regulator, my snorkel as well. So this is really, really nice. And it keeps everything tidy, which I like. I'll just close this. So this is our old rusty bike. You can fold it, so it's quite nice, but it's really, it has seen better days for sure. And here you can see the back end of the boat. I just put flags on here yesterday. So this is for one flag for each country that we visit. I had that on my backpack when I was out backpacking, so I thought that was a nice little idea. And we actually also just got the name on here. So this is the life raft and a new name. And the David's, oh, let's not talk about that. And here you can see the boat from the other side. We are currently in Bonaire. So this is the marina. And the other side. All right, so let's go to the front. This is the trampoline. Really good place to read a book or get a good tan. And this is our diving compressor. So we have our own compressor, so it's possible to just jump in the water. Let me just show you. All right, so this is how it looks. It's a bawa and it's actually brand new. And it fills all our diving bottles that we have here. All right, the last thing, our solar panels. We have 4 flexible panels up here. It's 250 watts each, so quite a lot actually, but we like our power. All right, so I guess that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the boat tour and that I got around to the basics. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them in the comment area below. And also make sure you subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. Have a really nice weekend and greetings from Bonaire!